Hi. Greetings. Thank you for coming to Dhyanapada Yoga. If you're here for the second time, I'm so honored you're coming back. Thank you. Today we're going to need a bolster or a couple of pillows. Firm pillows would be helpful. A couple of blocks. And why don't we actually start on the blocks right away? We do a yin class. It's gonna be I'm gonna try very hard to be mostly silent in this class. At least I'll be after the instruction to get into the pose, I'll be silent for about 3 minutes to hold it. All right, so why don't we just sit on the blocks, all of our toes, stretch out the bottom of your feet first, things first, and exhale, let go. Some deep breaths, seven deep breaths here. Let each inhale fill your belly and hold for 5 seconds, and then let your exhale be longer. Okay, exhale completely. Exhale. Exhaling for 8 counts and inhale for 5. Hold for 6. Exhale for 8. Inhale for 6. Hold for 7. Exhale for 9. Inhale. Just inhale and exhale naturally. Take your left hand behind your back. Maybe hold on to your waist or your right arm. Take your right ear towards your right shoulder and breathe into the left side of your neck. You can even reach your head back and forward to see where the tension lives in your neck. Breathe. Take your right hand over your head. Just let your hand rest on top of your head. Take your left hand to your left shoulder. Just lightly, gently assist it downward. Both hands and feel the tension lift off your head and neck and shoulders. Deep breath. Take your left hand, right hand behind you. Hold on to your left elbowish. Take your right ear towards, I'm sorry, your left ear towards your left shoulder. Breathe into the right side of your neck. Take your left hand, rest it on top of your head. Take your right hand towards the floor, breathe. Take Take your right hand on your right shoulder and stretch them away from each other. And release your hands on your lap. Feel the effects of the pose. Hold on to your toes with both hands. Take them off of the mat. Pull your toes towards your back. And let's release that. Hold, put your hands on your heels and put your forehead to the ground for rabbit pose. Roll towards the back of your head, holding onto your feet. And release the blocks. I'm going to do 90 and 90. So just your left knee is in front. Swan pose. Left knee is in front. Your right knee is facing the outer edge of the mat. Like you could just see, maybe if you see me feel like this. All right. You just gotta be where you're comfortable here, and maybe grab a bolster, a pillow if you want. Start on your shoulders, or your you can start with your elbows on the ground or on a bolster. Put your hands in your head and see gradually how deep you want to take this. You might feel ready to just put your head down or put your head on a block. See what works for you. Breathe. Lock yourself up. Let's take the deer twist. So look over the right shoulder. alternate twist. Look over your left shoulder. Let's switch legs. Right leg is now in front. And fold over to your degree of comfort and relax. And come up nice and slow. Twist over. Now we're gonna look over the left shoulder. A little strong. Unwind out of this. Now, I have tried this without blocks and without a pillow over the blocks, and I found it very uncomfortable. So I'm going to suggest that you put the blocks on the lowest level and put a pillow right underneath the blocks. And you can take your hips right up to the pillow and lie down. Your arm is going to come right out of your shoulder. Lie down like that. And your left arm is going to go right over your head. And breathe into the side body. Surrender. release your left hand. Come up nice and slowly, bend your right knee, push off with your hands. Now, this time we're going to face the pillow. With your twist. So, top of your body's on the pillow. Yeah, I'm going to put my left ear on the mat. You may want to switch directions of your head. I'm going to keep my left ear on the pillow because I'm going to do something different with my knee in a few breaths. Now, I'm going to come to the left knee, maybe heel toe, and I'm going to take the right knee to the right, like half rock kind of position. I'm going to take my right ear to the mat. Maybe you want to fix the blocks so they're longish. That'll give you a more secure hold underneath you. If it gets too intense, maybe you want to get rid of the blocks and maybe you just want to lie down. It doesn't look like much, but it is a pretty deep pose. So you have to figure out what works for you. I'm going to come onto my elbows, press my knee, left knee to the mat. Walk my feet underneath in just a couple of cat cows to release the spine again.
Exhale, chin to chest. Tailbone is reaching towards your knees. Exhale, maybe even on your fingertips. Inhale, look up, chin up. Press the tops of your feet into the mat. Press your hips up and round again. One more up, one more cow. Excellent, let's switch directions. So, first one is just side body love. So, set up the blocks so they're starting, they're touching your hip. Put a pillow. Now, for this one, I do like the blocks more square because it gives me more room for my side body. So, remember the left ear, left arm comes right out of the shoulder socket, right. Your head just goes right over it. And then the right ear, right arm comes right over your ear. So your ears, your arms are between, your ears are between your arms. Breathe. Surrender and let go.
Okay, now it's time to change the direction of this side body, love. So, kind of like a left leg is buttoned up again. It's like a little bit like a pigeon, but actually supported. Kind of rest on the right side, right cheek. You're resting your core on the blocks. Yeah, the stomach is resting, chest is resting, everything is supported. Let go. Now very gently and slowly come up, press into your hands. You can actually remove the blocks now. I'm gonna get a twist for the other side of the spine, like taking the knee out, like you're hugging a pillow, like you're an half frog. And just put your arms under the pillow or in a T and put your left cheek on the mat. So your left knee is bent, your left cheek. It's okay to cushion up, but underneath the left knee if it's a little tender on the floor.
come on up to your hands.
We can.
Get rid of the pillow. And your left knee is still hiked up. Just press into your left hand and send your right arm through. Thread the needle. We're going to take a twist. So take as much as your shoulder onto the mat as you can. And just rotate around for a twist. Look over your left shoulder. Wind out of this. Press your left foot into the mat. Right foot into the mat. Hug your knees into your chest. Bring your forehead to your knees. Drop side to side along that spine. Make circles with your knees. Hold on to each knee with your hand. Rolling through your sacrum. Switch directions. Let your feet hit the floor. Send your knees to the left. Press into the outer inner edge of the right foot. Look over the right shoulder. Go the other way. Press into the inner edge of the left foot, look over your left shoulder. Windshield wipe your legs, rolling through your sacrum. When your right knee comes over, let's get the other side. So right knee hits the ground. Right hand is pressing into the ground, left hand threads the needle. As much shoulder as you can to open up, to twist over the right shoulder. knees can come into your chest, hug them in, lift your head. Release the spine. Roll onto one side. We're gonna come up for heart opener back bend here. So you can use your blocks. This goes bottom of your rib cage, so along your spine, probably go till right here. And your head rests on the one behind it. So set that up. With yin, your body temperature really drops in yin, so you know you want to make sure that you have a blanket if you're cold, or if you want to shut the air or adjust the temperature. I can use this on my feet. Now come to elbows. Press your heart lift into your elbows. Very slowly. You might need to use your hands here too. It's all good. You can remove the blocks. Take constructive rest so your feet are about mat width apart. And then you just lie on your back and knock your knees together and feel the effects. Feel how flat your back feels on the floor. Your entire sacrum is almost getting pulled away from your back in this pose. It feels, should feel like a nice stretch for your lower back. Releasing your hips. Okay, now roll onto one side of your body. And then push yourself up. Seated pose. We're going to do a wide leg forward fold. So stretch your legs out to whatever degree you're comfortable. It does not have to be that wide. Remember, we're not chasing sensation in yin. We're just surrendering and seeing what comes. Judge nothing. Allow. Some moments will be blissful, some moments will be irritating. Just breathe through it. Try not, once you get all the wiggles out to get into the pose, try to stay still in the pose and let stillness find you. All right, so we're just gonna fold over the support of a pillow. So let your whole belly rest on the pillow or bolster. I'll let you know to flip your head halfway in between the stretch.
So right now I'm taking my right ear and I'm putting it on the pillow. switch your other ear to the pillow. So come on up slowly, do a forward fold. Make this as supportive as you want. You can use a bolster on your legs. You can just hang over your legs. I've seen a lot of people in yin just hanging over like this. It's okay in yin. You gotta do you. Just I always have to have my head supported, so I would probably keep my hands on a bolster and keep my, if I was going to hang, I would have my head resting in my hands or my, I'm going to fold over to the degree of my comfort. I encourage you to do the same, just let go.
nice and slowly. Let's release out of that. Move the pillow. And the blocks could come to the side of you. We'll just lay it down on our backs. We're a single happy baby, so left right leg is out to the right. And then just really see if you can pull your hip and your knee down. You can hold on to your toes, inner foot, outer foot, doesn't really matter, whatever you want. Wherever you're comfortable breathing. Bend the left knee, left foot's on the floor, right ankle crosses over the left knee, press your right knee away from your body, and hug your left leg in for reclined pigeon. Drop your left hip, foot down. Arms in a T, take your right foot to the mat. Hold on to your right ankle. Look over your right shoulder. Release the right foot. Take the feet together, knees to the ceiling. Let your right knee drop over to your left. left foot, outer edge of the foot, just kind of ground the happy baby, single leg happy baby, breathe. The right knee, put the left ankle over the right knee, push the left knee away from your body, breathe. Thread the needle, pull the right leg close to your body. Surrender here for a few minutes. Now put the right foot on the mat. Take the left foot out to the, let it drop to the left, and the right knee and the left foot and everything just drops to the left. Look over your left shoulder and hold on to your left ankle with your right hand, just to give it some security. Alicia neck. Put your feet together, knees come to the ceiling. And drop your left knee out to the left. Drop your knees to the left, stretch your arms over your head. Roll to one side, make a pillow with your arm. And then push yourself up. I just want to do a couple more forward fold. Diamond now, so feet will be in a diamond. So they don't have to be too close to your body. And you can actually have a block between your feet. And you work towards putting your head on the block. So if you want to start on a higher level, look on your wrists. Make pillows with your hands. Just gradually take it as low as it wants to go or not. Just keep breathing, you'll feel this in the hips and the lower back. Lean to your left if you want to. One more stretch before Shavasana. I like to take Shavasana at the wall. If you have wall space, I encourage you to do this. I want to do one more forward fold at the wall. So if you don't have wall space, you could just do this lying on your back with your legs over your head, pulling your legs close to your body. So my feet are on the door, if you can see.
I'm just gonna scoop myself up to the door. Work my hands behind me. I'm just gonna come to my elbows. My hips a little close to the wall. I'm gonna grab a block for onto my hips. Just gonna assist this waterfall pose. And also it helps, it makes me feel as if I'm getting a massage pull in my spine. So I've got a wiggle of myself in there anyway that's appropriate, I guess. And I'm just gonna rest like right on the edge. The edge of the block is going into my sacrum. And I'm just gonna let it do its thing as long as it takes to pull my sacrum away from my lower back. Just surrender completely, let go of the practice, let go of your breath. Enjoy the floaty sensation. you're ready, take your knees into your chest and kind of just roll off the block, off the wall. Come to a little seated position. Maybe a 2 minute meditation if you're up for it, or you can just lie down in Shavasana or take a twist or anything else you want. I like this drop-in space for grounding and guidance. So scan your body, shoulders back, head is towards the wall, spine is long, chin is slightly tucked. Become real curious about the inner landscape of you. Letting the thoughts float by, not attaching to anything at all, allowing everything. Just observe. Excuse me. May the rest of your day unfold with grace. May you be happy, may be peaceful, may you be filled with love, may be joyous and radiant and brilliant, because that's what you're meant to be. Namaste. Keep going back. Share, like, subscribe, spread the love. Blessed year.